And this one is a nice question, also from a new plugin that we had recently in FL Studio, which is the NewTone. I think it's NewTime. So one of the things that I think FL Studio lacks a little bit is this audio manipulation tools. Because if you want to stretch and do some time alignment in your samples, it's really hard to do in FL Studio. And I still think it's not the best way to do it because you are jumping between tools to do different things. But it's also a matter of workflow. So if you get the workflow right, you will be able to do this without even thinking about it or internalize this and be able to do it. But it's kind of a pain, a little bit of a pain. For instance, I'm comparing with Ableton Live. Live is really nice for time alignment of loops. You just open up the editor or double click on the sample and you will have the editor. And then you can manipulate different, you can add markers and manipulate the markers, and you can change the timing of your samples a little bit better. And it's all included or built in into the tool. In FL Studio, we have to have extra tools to do that. And I will show you how to do that. Okay, so let's go into FL Studio. Sorry, just a small break to drink some water. So let's open up here a sample. By the way, let's do... Let me show you first how I would do this before, and then we can choose, or I can show you how to do that after. So let's see that we have here some drum loops, and let's use the breaker one. It's a classic loop from FL Studio. Let's put this to 100, stretch this out. So let's say that we have this loop here. Let me make this bigger. And let me also bring the volume down a little bit. If we look here and if we put this in step mode, we see that the loop is quite aligned in terms of, we have this swing stuff, but it's quite aligned. But let's say that I want to add, that I wanted to change, for instance, this kick here. And instead of having this kick here, I wanted to have here. So how I would do it, I would just cut this one here, like so. And I would probably move this here, something like that. But then I would have this type of stop there. So what I would do is I would make this unique. And then I would stretch this out like so. And maybe I could, for instance, put on E3 generic to keep the same tonality. But it will not be perfect. And maybe this was not the best option because we have this here a little bit off timing. So it didn't help too much. Let me see. For instance, here in this one, how I would do this, I would do this here. Let me take out the stretch. And I could stretch this one out. So I would have to do make unique and stretch this one out. And let's do E3 generic. So this one didn't work that well. So let me put this back into the place it was. But this one worked a little bit better. As you can see, this one sounds a little bit more like the original sound, but with the new timing structure. But as you've seen, I had to create Make Unique. And if I go now to my channel rack, I have 1, 2, and 3 copies of the same loop with different timings. As you can see, let me open this one. So we have 1 time, 2 times, and 3 times, and they are all different. So you would create and necessary copies of the same file. So the way to do it now with the extra tool that we have is using NewTime. And if we go here to New and we open up NewTime, we can go here and we can just bring up the sample and it analyzed the sample. And as you can see now, the sample before it was in only two bars, but now it's one, two, three and something bars. So what we have to do is click here and you see now the arrows for left and right. So click here and not here. How can I drag everything? Let me see. There's probably an option to do this. Oops, not like that. Let me select everything. Okay, so now that's it. So you can select all of the loop and then move it to where you need it. It will select or it will move everything around. So now if I look at this, it should be in time. It's actually not entirely in time. I don't know why. It should sync the same tempo. Okay, so we had there and it was not synced. So let me do this again. How do I clean this one here? Let me see. Let's see, preset, no. Let me do this again. I don't use this tool a lot, so that's why I need some time also to check this out. So let's do here, let's bring the loop and let's put this in sync. And now we have everything in time. So that's it. Okay, so let's select these. Let's make a loop. Okay, so now we have a loop. And to do what I did before, you just go here, click on this part here, and then you just move this one. But you can see it's a little bit different. So it sounds different than the other one. So it has also some drawbacks where you don't, how can I say, it's not entirely the same thing. So it also changes the pitch here. And let's see, I can also click on Alt and now I have control to have it a little bit more swing. So let's see now if I bring this into the playlist, if it would sound better in the playlist rather than here. So I actually prefer the other way I did it. Sounds way better. But this one is basically the way to do it. And you might have some samples that are not entirely on time. And you can adjust them using the new tone and this, or new time, sorry. This is a great tool to help you set up some of the loops or change some of the timing of the loops. Might be something easy, might be a little bit harder, but this is the way to do it. And you can do it very easily and simple and reuse the loops or realign your loops to the tempo and make sure that the loops are a little bit thin. Another disadvantage is that if the sample is not entirely on the same time as your project, you will have to create markers by every single thing. So you probably can use, let me see if we have options here to create markers independently or automatically. I don't think so. So yeah, this tool is good, but I think it's not the easiest way to work with loops or to align loops in FL Studio. That's why I jump between DAWs. I like some features of some DAWs, and I use them for quick fixes and or even for entire features. For instance, I like to make my beats in FL Studio, but I like to mix my beats in Studio One. So that's why I do it. And if I need to align loops, I will probably do it in Ableton Live, because I think the features in Ableton Live are way better to that, for that, in terms of alignment loops. And that's what I'm saying, like in terms of aligning, it's not the easiest way to do it in FL Studio, and you have to jump between tools, and then you have to load samples, and if you need to change stuff later, you will have to load again the sample, make the change that you need, and then re-import the sound into the playlist, and create a new insert or a new instance or sampler here with a new sound. So it's not the most effective way, I think, but the way FL Studio is constructed is a nice, how can I say, the way the workflow works in FL Studio, I think that's the only way that they found to do that.